NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Highmark Stadium in upstate New York.
Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Minnesota Vikings and the Buffalo Bills.
And we are underway in Buffalo. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Allen off the play fake. This is brought in by the tight end, Tommy Sweeney. Devin Singletary with his first carry of the game. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Throwing is Allen on third. Got it complete to Khalil Shakir. And they work this well upfield across the 45. They run for the first time with James Cook.
And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Here's Allen to throw it. Caught right side, Davis. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him? Either fellow receivers or offensive linemen. That makes that play a really nice timing play. And sometimes it can break big.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. Here's Allen. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Just a gain of a couple there. And it's 3rd and 4 now.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 24-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. A full start backs him up 5, 1st and 15. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. His throw incomplete. Finally an incompletion. He was 5 of 5 before that last throw to start this game.
So he is human. All right, so we found out after the way he began, okay, he can have an incompletion here or there. But I love what they've done right from the word go. They just need to pay it off with a touchdown now.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down. They'll try the middle with Cook. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for 3rd down. So from 2nd and long, now we go to 3rd and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in 4-down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he gets the 1st down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11.
We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now in Buffalo. It's the Bills in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Going to give this one to Singletary. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Singletary again. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. The defense was ready for the run pass option, diagnosed it perfectly.
Not only did they stack him up at the point of attack, but he was met by a host of light colored jerseys.
The Bills on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. To the air, Allen. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The sack coming from big Dalvin Tomlinson. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
So the first points of the night belong to our home team as they're able to take the opening kickoff and at least get 3 points out of it.
Yeah, and that helps the crowd, right? Helps people feel good about why they're there watching this game. They move the ball well on their opening drive.
Nwangu now from his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. And the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. They start the drive with Cook. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Taron Johnson made the stop.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about what they do.
And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long. On play action, they'll throw. Loss of 10 as multiple defenders get to him.
As I was watching the play unfold, my eyes immediately went to the referee because I wanted to see, was he going to put those two hands over his head and that universal signal for a safety? But as at the 1 yard line, you know you're playing with fire when you get sacked that close to them.
And from their own end zone, it's a fake. And this is caught.
I know, without even asking, without even looking in your direction, that you are not a fan of that call.
Oh, I wish you had looked, Brandon, because I was actually thinking this would be the perfect time for a fake.
Right, right.
Yeah, you're right. This doesn't make any sense to me at all. This deep in your own territory. Look, I'm all for being unconventional. That part's cool, and I get it. But this deep? I just don't think it was the right time to make that call.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. On the counter, this is Singletary. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now 3rd down coming up.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
From the gun, it's Allen. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Chandon Sullivan. And the Vikings are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And you figure, Charles, they have enough time here in the first half, more than a minute, to put a drive together at least. He's got daylight. He's at the 40, the 20.
A big play there on the catch and run. 79 yards.
I'm going rhetorical on you here. Could that pass have been delivered any better to the receiver downfield?
Not at all. And when he catches that, he didn't even have to break stride. Full speed. That's why he got all that yardage after the catch.
Timing, timing, timing.
And now whistles and a flag. And I think we got a jump here.
And that'll be a free 5 yards for the offense.
Just like a tennis match, that's just an unforced error. Stay alert, don't jump early, and give them free yardage.
So the ball's moved to about the one after the penalty, first and goal. On second and goal, Cook waiting in the backfield all alone. And they will take a knee here. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. This Buffalo defense has stood their ground. This is third and goal. To throw, Cousins. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. A 1 yard touchdown pass. And the Vikings will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Kevin O'Connell choosing to leave his guys out there. They'll go for two. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Greg Joseph on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. McKenzie now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. With this slim deficit closing in on the end of the first half, we'll see if they can move this at least into field goal range and try to get three out of this drive. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Now looks to throw. Going deep for Diggs. Into a double team and it's intercepted. It's Cameron Dantzler who picks it. And the Vikings will take over here just shy of the 30.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Final play of the half, Cousins. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. They'll throw now on the final play. And that will be incomplete as well. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Again, it's Cook. And he'll be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 38. So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped.
Got an open man finding Jefferson.
And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line. From the red zone now, Cousins. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Touchdown! T.J. Hockenson from 13 yards out as his guys are able to extend their lead. Joseph now to have the PAT. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. Liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead and, oh, there's a fake, and he's gonna get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward, it's just not there.
So risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. It's Tyler Bass on for the extra point attempt. And oh, he clanks it off the right upright, and it's no good. Boy, it's only a one-score game, third quarter, mind you, but they're going to go for the onside kick right here. And the Vikings able to recover, the hands teamed up, and the ball is knocked out. Now this is picked up by the Bills, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside. And Allen going to be intercepted for the third time. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football.
You've got to know, as a quarterback, that's going to be tough to outthink this guy in the defensive backfield. He's been at it 11 years now, so he knows all the ins and outs of the position. And he's in the right spot there to come up with the interception.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
Throwing is Cousins. And he's got this to Jefferson. Touchdown, Vikings! Justin Jefferson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Kevin O'Connell choosing to lead his guys out there. They'll go for two.
Cook, they'll try and run it. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. McKenzie now from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
At this point in the game and the situation they're in, partner, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps, and soon.
We're in the third quarter in upstate New York with a second and 10. Now Allen. He's got his target. It's the tight end Knox. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Allen and Knox teaming up there for Buffalo first down. Again, they'll throw with Allen. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he'll be brought down at the 27. On second down, Cook. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. It'll be first and goal when we come back. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. On play action, Allen. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Singletary will take this over the line. Touchdown, Buffalo. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the 4th.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Nwangu now from his end zone. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They run again on first down, Cook. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Cousins now.
Oh, going for Jefferson downfield.
And this would have been intercepted if he could have gotten the feed in. He didn't, so it's incomplete. Boy, that one really could have turned this thing upside down. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3. Cousins.
Setting up the screen for Cook. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
And when you have success throwing the football, the old cliche becomes true. The playbook opens up wide, and these screen passes, they become even more difficult to stop.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 47. Now Cousins. Out to the left there and complete to the tight end, Hockenson. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. 12 more yards there and another first down. Cousins gives way to Cook. And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line. On first and 10, Cousins. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Throwing again on second down. Cousins. Open man is Osborne. He's got it. Touchdown! K.J. Osborne from 19 yards away. And the Vikings get an important score there to extend their lead here this fourth quarter. Joseph connects on the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. From the six. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And pretty good field position here. He's out of bounds right at the 35. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive.
For this offense, Charles, remember the last time they were out here, marched it nearly the full length of the football field, and a lot of the attack went through the air, so now they're seeing if they can duplicate that performance.
Okay, if I show my age a little bit, partner, because I can hear my high school coach, John Ford. I can hear his voice in my head. Laddie, when you put the ball in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad. But the way the game's being played now, this is just part of what they do, so I don't think they should change anything at all. They've been dominant. Keep throwing it around.
16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down. Throwing now is Allen. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now Allen. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And a penalty flag comes in as that one winds up incomplete. But the contact is going to move the ball well downfield.
So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but the flag comes out for interference.
And now you're set up right on the doorstep of the goal line. 1 yard away changes what your play calls are going to be.
Here's Allen. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Allen. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
They do tack on the extra point as well. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. The Bills say they have it, and they do. And the Bills have recovered. So they've accomplished half the mission, Charles. They get the onside kick. They do need a touchdown here, but they've got some time to do it.
In the excitement, there's no need to press. plenty of time. They have the opportunity. Now they just need to execute and finalize things.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Up the middle, it's Cook. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Allen. Throw left side complete. That's Hines. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Throwing is Allen. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner. We're watching them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now Allen. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down. Back to throw, Allen. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Nearly an interception. If that one's picked off, it's over. So a new lease on life, so to speak.
A lot of times when you're in coverage, you're so focused on the man and the coverage that sometimes the ball, if it arrives, it surprises you. That may have happened to him in that situation.
And he's brought down short by 1 yard. It's a third down gain of 4. And with just inside of 10 seconds to go, they'll burn their final timeout. 9 seconds left. Now Allen, gotta have this one. And he's got it. It's caught for a touchdown. And they have taken the lead here in the final seconds. Charles, that drive was perfect, methodical, executed so well, and they grabbed that lead with almost no time left for a last gasp from the other side.
No way you could have drawn up a better final drive, because not only did they keep their eyes on the end zone, they made sure they bled the clock out as well and denied their opponent a chance to respond. That's just terrific situational football to end this one.
To the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. It's a squib kick that still makes its way down inside the 15. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy.
And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick.